Welcome to My Hometown, the program that explores clubs, organizations, businesses, and issues across Nassau and Suffolk counties and sheds light on the different towns that are making a difference.
Hello and welcome to My Hometown. My name is Bill Horan, and I'm here with Nassau Community College student Corey Kaufman. And today we're shining the spotlight on a studio that is literally taking dancing to new heights.
I like to dance, but I'm afraid of heights. Not sure if I want to continue this interview, and it hasn't even gotten off the ground yet.
Corey, don't worry. We'll stay grounded for now. Today we're going to learn about aerial fitness with our guest, Regina Armand. She's the owner of the Aerial Loft, a dance and fitness studio in Mineola. Regina, welcome to My Hometown on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Regina, first of all, you have to explain to us, because that's a brand new term. I've never heard of the two words aerial fitness put together. So can you explain to us and the audience, what is aerial fitness?
For sure. So aerial fitness, you can think of it similar to like circus. We have aerial suit, aerial silks, aerial hammock, aerial hoop, and pretty much it just means that the equipment is ascended from the air. So there's a beam that's on the ceiling and the equipment is hanging down from it.
So, again, I'm looking at you and you're looking at me. You expect me to get up close to the ceiling on these springy type things? Is that it?
So the equipment does come down to the floor, and we do provide crash mats that are, so it's something that
I noticed. See how she said that? As soon as she looked at me, she right away with the crash mat. She knows what's going to happen. You probably had my old gym teacher from 50 years ago talking to you and saying, get the crash mats if he comes in. So, okay, it's good you're prepared for me, right?
Yes.
I can land and
absolutely.
I'm going to be nice and cushy and soft like a big mattress?
Absolutely. Okay, safety is one of our top priorities.
With me, it better be. Okay, thank you.
So how did you get into teaching the aerial arts?
Sure. So I actually started off running track for about 6 years. I did a little cheerleading in college, and I've always been pretty active. When I graduated from high school, I actually seen a YouTube video of a pole dancer, and she was like doing a huge competition, and it like broke. I was immediately intrigued because I always associated pole dancing, pole dancing to something that's done in like a club or something like that. So I said, you know what, I'm going to go try it out. And I went to the city and I took my first class, and I was immediately hooked. I was just like fascinated by like how much muscle, like your body is working, how much it challenges you. And it was just completely different than what I had assumed. And I got hooked. And then I started wondering, why aren't there facilities like this in Queens, in Long Island? And that's when I started branching out, renting spaces and teaching, and started building a following in Long Island. And then that's where 6 months ago, I opened up the doors to the Aerial Loft.
And you have a background in dance?
Yes, I do.
Fill us in on that, because is that something that should be necessary, or do you seem to attract a lot of dancers to this?
So not at all. I only had I went to a dance studio for about maybe 2 or 3 years, and I did like ballet, I did a jazz and hip hop and stuff like that. But it's not something that you need to start pole dancing, which is the great part about it. I have people who walk in the studio and they're like, I've never worked out before, I've never danced, I've never done anything. And it's totally fine, because we start you off at the most basic intro level. And the thing is that your journey goes with your body. So it's like, you know, if you need more time just to build up your shoulder strength or build up your core strength, we work with you to make sure that, you know, that the training is specifically for you.
Now, that's a great point, Corey, because mm-hmm. When I see people doing these kind of things, I think of, and they do look like gymnasts, and like you, they're physically fit. And if it's a male, where you can see his shoulders and muscles, he's sinewy, there's no fat on, kind of like a basketball player, but more normal size, that they jump around and do all this.
Yeah.
Were you always into fitness? I know you said a cheerleader and track, but was that always a big part of your life?
It always was a big part. I've always been pretty active.
Now, you talk about dance. Mm-hmm. And you're smiling, looking at me again, because, Corey, you've never seen me dance, but nobody wants to see me dance. At weddings, they pay me to sit down, they give me an extra cheeseburger, and they say, sit there, please don't dance, the other people are getting upset. So do I have to have some skill in dancing, or is it the coordination that helps?
Nope, not at all. So those clients who do come in with a gymnastics background or a dance background, they do tend to pick it up a little bit faster just with the coordination. But most of my clients are everyday people. They come in with no background at all, and they're able to pick it up with over time. It's like anything, you work on it, you get better at it.
And it seems like it's fun, too. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's
so much fun.
What's the word today? Would I be using the right term if I say low impact or no impact? Because, you know, some things we're bouncing on, like a wrestler would be bouncing on the ring. Mm-hmm. If I'm lifting weights, mm-hmm. I got 100 pounds over my head, and I better bring it down or else it's going to hurt. But this is like bungee cords, again. Am I using?
So it's a aerial silk and what that, yeah.
Silks.
Yes. Yeah. The silks that we use are low impact silk, and that just means that they're stretchier, especially for beginners. But not only do we have like the silks classes in the hammock, we also offer the hoop, which is a metal circle. So it's a hoop and you hold onto it as well. Yeah, it is a lot of fun, but you do experience some bruising from it. We call them like badges, just means that you worked hard. But yeah.
Corey, when Regina said hoop, do you know what I pictured? I thought she was really setting me up. You know when the little gerbils when you buy them? I thought she was going to say there's a hoop. And if it's someone like you who's not too athletic, who can't dance, I'm going to put you in that hoop. And you're just going to run circles for about an hour. You'll get tired. You'll go away. And you won't be a problem to you. So that's really what I was envisioning. I thought you were setting me up. So at least you're being nice to me. Thank you. Now I get the picture better.
So we interview a lot of business owners who have, you know, these kind of dance studios or these kind of out there fitness studios. How competitive would you say the fitness scene is on Long Island? And how do you stand out?
Mm-hmm. So there are a lot of fitness centers on Long Island, gyms and CrossFit and all those things. But there's actually there's not a lot of studios that offer pole dancing and aerial fitness as we do. And also we're the only studio on Long Island that offers the kids classes as well. So the kids are able to come and take the silks. They're able to try the hoop classes, the handstand classes. So we're different in that sense that we offer classes for children, to adults, men and women.
Regina, let me just insert, like, what age would kids come in at this?
Kids right now, they can start at the age of 4 for our Saturday classes.
Really? Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then all the other classes, it's 8 and up.
I would think kids would love this.
Oh, they do.
This would be, something that, because they're so rubberized, yeah, let's call it, they're not afraid of things.
Yeah, they're not.
We older people are afraid. They get up there and they have fun with it, and they don't care if they don't look perfect, mm-hmm, because they're enjoying it. It's exercise, and it's burning things up for them. So,
yeah. How do they do on the wheel?
on the hoop. They do really well on the hoop. They love the hoop because you can do like a bunch of different shapes and stuff, and they're usually pretty bendy. So it's mm-hmm, they love that as well.
Regina, Long Island seems to be somewhat of a unique place, like every place is in mm-hmm, the way we do things. We had a supermarket executive who came in and said, "I guess nobody cooks on Long Island because their hot bar does so well." Looking at Long Island from that view with exercise, how would you describe Long Island? Are we exercise crazy? Are we lazy? Are we into certain ones and not others? Is this the next big thing that's coming?
Yeah, I definitely feel like it's the next big thing. It's just people have to try it because there's such a stigma and people just don't know what it is or what it's like. So I think a lot of people on Long Island are into fitness and trying new things. Is just getting people to come through the doors and actually just give it a try.
Yeah, yeah. I guess that's what we all have imaginary fears, yeah. I guess what it is. And once we do it, it's like, hey, this is really neat.
Yeah.
And so what was the process of getting the studio open? You told us it's you were telling us about the space a little bit before the show started.
Yeah. So the process was pretty long because we have to have a space that's big enough to be able to, you know, support like what we do. Mm-hmm. And also the ceiling height is very important so that we can hang the equipment. Once I did find a space, it took me about maybe 4 months. I had to get approval from the town of Mineola, which is how I think you guys found me. So I went through that whole process and I had to sit in front of the board and get approval to be able to run the studio there. And then we got the doors open. The mayor of Mineola, he came to our grand opening. We had a huge ribbon cutting and it was amazing. But like amazing.
Did he get up on the bungee?
He didn't. He came and took pictures with the kids in the silks, but I told him next time.
Well, you are listening to My Hometown on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 at WHPC. My name is Corey Kaufman, along with Bill Horan, and today we're talking about aerial fitness with Regina Armand, owner of the Aerial Loft, a dance and fitness studio in Mineola.
Regina, I'm just thinking, that must have been a very interesting meeting at the board in Mineola. Can you tell us about it? And what were the probably one or two most interesting questions that you received?
I think the most interesting question, they were all just so intrigued. They were like, what is it? Like,
yeah, that's what I
How
would.
Does it work? So it was just pretty much explaining it to them. And then they kind of got the idea. And then other than that, everybody was so supportive. I was very nervous leading up to this meeting. But everybody was really supportive and they were excited about it, which was a really cool thing.
Because I have to say one thing, that you use the term pole dancing, and when we think of that, two things come to my mind. Mm-hmm. Jerry Springer and strippers, okay? And that's just what the way we react. So it has kind of a negative connotation,
exactly.
But I know that's an exercise and dance move, and that, you know, ballerinas use that, etc. So did that scare them a little bit? Did they think you were opening up a wrestling arena, or you had people flying out the windows?
I think that once I started to speak about it and I explained it, there wasn't any more. Like, they were like, oh, like, this is for fitness, this is for fun, this is empowerment. So then that stigma kind of just was like, okay, that's not what she's running here. So,
and that's great. And from a business viewpoint, you know, our main streets are changing. If we see a lot of times, we see old businesses that are now closed or glassed over, and this may be the new thing, people coming in for it, different types of exercising, which would benefit all of us because we spend too much time in the fast food place. And that's only fair that you get us in good shape, etc.
So tell us about the studio. What's the studio all about? You were talking about empowerment. If you could expand on that a little bit.
For sure. So at my studio, we're a safe place for, as I said, men and women, children and adults. And it's just a place for you to come in, leave like everything that's happening at home, at work, at the door. You come in, it's a safe place. Everybody's super positive. Mm-hmm. The environment, the energy is really warm. And you come in, you have fun. Not only do you have fun, you're getting an exercise in, and you just enjoy yourself.
It's open to all body types,
all levels.
He's looking at me when he says that. You know that? All body types. Such a wise guy. Now, Regina, let me ask you, how many different, is there just one type of class, or are there many different, this is something none of us know about. We think of the gym as lifting some weights or maybe the machinery. Tell us about the different type of classes you would run.
Sure. So we offer a wide range of classes, from pole dancing classes, the aerial hoop class, the aerial silks, aerial hammock, kids classes, flexibility classes, stretch class, handstand classes, and we also offer an array of different workshops. So like salsa classes, we'll offer like a soca class or something like that. So we try to bring in different things for the community to try out as well.
That's neat. That's a lot of, it seems like a lot of good ideas.
Yeah.
When people walk out of the first class, what? I don't want to say hurts, but where do they find soreness? Even the first time I went to a gym, they just showed me the exercises with no weight. And because I was doing it, and I was a little tense, the next day I was sore.
Yeah.
So what's going to be sore when I come out of there?
Well, everything is a full body workout. So you'll kind of feel everything. Usually most people are like, oh, my shoulders are like, when they stretch, because we give them a full warm up for about 15 to 20 minutes. And they're just like, wow, like, I didn't even know like how tight I was. So they kind of feel it all over.
That's a good feeling, though.
Yeah,
that's why we go for exercise. By the way, we've been talking so much about it. Would you tell our audience, where are you located? Mm-hmm. And is there a website when they can find out more about it?
Yeah, so we're located at 267 Horton Highway in Mineola, Long Island. Mm-hmm. And the website is theaerialloft.com. And the same thing with our social media is on Instagram, we're The Aerial Loft, and as well as on Facebook, The Aerial Loft.
And again, you're in Mineola, and I think you said to me you're about one block off of Jericho Turnpike. So if people are looking for you, that's kind of a landmark street that most people know.
And is it you teaching the classes, or how many instructors do you have?
So right now, I teach classes as well as 7 other instructors.
Mm-hmm. And how big are the classes?
So for the pole dancing classes, we only allow up to 12 clients. And then for the aerial classes, we allow up to 10. So the classes are actually more intimate. You know, it's not too big, and you have a lot more interaction with the instructors. So more one-on-one attention.
Mm-hmm. Regina, who typically comes in to take these classes? What I guess would be your demographic?
A wide range. I get lots of moms. I get lawyers, doctors, teachers, fitness enthusiasts, children, kids, dancers. So it's so many. It's not just like a specific one market. It's kind of like anybody.
Do people tend to use this with other meaning like they may go to the gym on Saturday, what we call the typical gym that mm-hmm. we think of, and come to you for a variety? Or is this exclusive, more or less? Do they do this? How does that work with people?
Absolutely. So people do go to the gym as well and then use this more, I guess, for like toning.
I was going to say, that sounds really good for that.
Exactly, because it builds muscle and strengthens your core and stuff like that. So even myself, I get to the gym at least 3 or 4 times a week as in addition to doing this as well.
That's why you're in such good shape. Now, what does someone wear? I mean, again, I have to admit, never taken part in this. If I go to the gym, I throw a sweatshirt on, sweatpants mm-hmm. ideally, or in the summer shorts. Mm-hmm. What would someone wear for this type of workout?
Sure. For our aerial classes, we have our clients wear either a t-shirt or long sleeve shirts, as well as long pants, because the silk and the hoop can actually like rub against your skin and irritate
Makes
it.
Sense.
So we have something to cover it. For pole dancing, we have the girls wear either like capri pants or shorts, and then maybe like a tank top with like, you know, proper sports bra and stuff like that. And that's just because the material of the pole, your skin helps to grip onto it. Mm-hmm. As if you're wearing a bunch of clothes, then you'll just slide right off. So you actually need your skin to help grip on the pole.
And if there's people who, like us here, I think today, mm-hmm. both of us, I think this is a new term for both Corey mm-hmm. and myself. Are there beginners classes? If someone walks in, you know, if everybody else knows what they're doing, you feel mm-hmm. kind of shy.
Exactly.
Do you have a special class for klutzes like me?
Exactly. So for our pole classes, it's intro to pole, so brand new, never taken a class. Everybody's in the same, starting off at the same place. For our aerial classes, it's a beginner class, and it's the same idea. First time, never done anything like this before. So they cater to those who, from the very beginning.
And how many men are taking these pole dancing classes?
So the pole dancing classes, I don't get a lot of males in those classes, but I do get a lot of males in our handstand classes and like our stretch classes, those guys who work out all the time. So they're like, I'm just so tight. So they come and take the stretch classes mm-hmm. as well.
Honestly, the stretch today, I think Tom Brady has made that a big thing, and a lot of football players, about just stretching your muscles, because it's never been my problem that I've had such big muscles that mm-hmm. I couldn't get clothes, etc. Mm-hmm. But you look at some of those people and you say, gee, they can be a normal size and everything else. How do they even get a shirt that fits or pants? Because yeah. some muscles are so expanded. But the gymnasts, and I guess that's what I associate mm-hmm. with your work, are always looking, you know, slender, mm-hmm. sinewy, the way we want to look, the mm-hmm. kind of the model that mm-hmm. most of us would want to look at, whatever age we're at. Are there any stigmas with aerial fitness?
Not so much with the aerial classes, but more so, as we spoke on, is the pole dancing and just, you know, associating to that. But other than that, it, you know, there's not a big stigma. It's once you try it out, you see that it's a workout, and you know, it's just like any other workout class, just different.
Now, it seems that, again, you call them the ribbons that people use and
the
work
silks,
back in the,
yeah.
and the silks and, mm-hmm. and the poles. Are there a lot of expenses we wouldn't think of for you as the owner, mm-hmm. As opposed to, like, if you go to the typical gym, there's a lineup. I think in my gym, I once counted 60 different machines that mm-hmm. they have, and that's for the mobility. That's bike machines mm-hmm. and rowing machines, et cetera. And then you go to the other side of the gym, and they have the weights and the usual mm-hmm. machines. Are there unusual things, or is it extra insurance because people are flying around in the air like birds?
Yeah, so we do get we have an aerial insurance that covers for specifically what we do. And we do have two huge rooms. So we have one is just the pole room, where the poles are attached up to a beam. And then on the other room, we have our aerial classes, where they're also rigged up to the ceiling as well.
Okay. Well, you are listening to My Hometown on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. My name is Corey Kaufman, along with Bill Horan, and today we're talking with Aerial Fitness with Regina Armand, owner of the Aerial Loft, a dance and fitness studio in Mineola. So tell us a little bit, what are the benefits of taking aerial dance classes?
Mm-hmm. So some of the benefits include workout. You're getting a full body workout. So shoulders, abs, core, legs, like all of that. All of your muscles are being worked. Not only that, is you're having fun. It's a safe place. It's challenging. And then it's also fun. Like you feel like you're flying. So it doesn't get any better than that in my book.
Now, Regina, you opened up this business in Mineola, and you told us how it was going before the Mineola board, which I'm glad that went so well, and they're so supportive, because we need new businesses, and it's kind of silly for a town, but, you know, unfortunately, the town politicians and elders are older. Something new takes them by surprise. I had never heard of this until today. What are some of the experiences you've had of running a business? Because you're a young person, and there must have been some things that you said to yourself, oh my gosh, I never even thought of this, and now I have to get that or this, or whether it's something over the windows because the sun is coming in, a type of insurance, clothing, you know, whatever. What took you by surprise?
So many things. Every day I run into something. I'm like, oh, I didn't know that. And as you mentioned, I'm a new business owner, so I keep that in mind every day. I know that there's something's going to come up, and I'm not going to know the answer. And maybe I have to do something a little differently. And I keep that in mind just so that I don't freak out and get overwhelmed. But it has been super challenging. So many new things that I learn every day. But rewarding before anything else. It's been the most rewarding thing I've done.
That's great to know. Now, let me ask you, when you do have one of those problems, and I don't mean this as a joke, do you have a mentor? Do you call the Aerial Loft Association of America and say, what do I do? I got a guy stuck on the ceiling and he won't come down. Or, you know, there's a little kid who just keeps bouncing continually. I can't stop him. Like, I'm making up silly problems. But I'm just wondering, because you're not the typical doctor's lawyer's office or school where they can call the next town. Mineola can call Carl Place or New Eye Park. I haven't heard too many Aerial Lofts. So who do you call for guidance, advice, et cetera?
So I do have a partner, my brother, and I call him for most of the advice that I need. And then there's also a ton of support groups online, like just so many that you – like, I didn't even think they all existed, but there's so many different support groups, and they ask questions like, what do you do if your rigging sounds like this? What do you do if this gets stuck or something like that? And those help so much because it's like, oh, like, I'll just type in rigging or I'll type in silks, and I'll get a ton of different articles and things like that that help me. So a lot of my information comes from sources from people who do this in different states and different countries and stuff, and I use those resources.
That's great. I mean, that's great, and I guess it's free too, so that's even better.
Exactly.
You don't have to go to a so-called expert and pay $300 or $400 or $500 an hour, so very smart. You're going to make it as an entrepreneur.
It's really interesting because it seems like it's a very like niche industry, but there's a lot more people in it than I would have thought. So what I want to know is what have been some of the challenges you faced while in the process of opening the studio?
One of the biggest challenges was looking for a space because I would see a space, I would get my heart set on it, I would see the entire setup happening, and then the next day I would get a call from the realtor or from the landlord, and they're like, oh, actually, we went in a different direction, or someone else signed the lease, or I even had a landlord who was just like, I just think you're too young. Like, I don't know how you're doing a business at such a young age. So there were a lot of challenges that I faced with finding an actual space, but I do believe that everything happens for a reason, and I'm so glad that I ended up at the space that I did.
How'd you come across this space?
Oh my gosh, it was actually really funny. I was on my way to sign the lease at a different space in Mineola, and my realtor said, before we go to this meeting, I want you to come look at this place. It's not on Jericho Turnpike, but it's right there behind the Jericho Terrace. And she said, there's no light in there. Let's just go take a look at it. So we went in there with flashlights, and we're like looking at the space, and I'm like, I think I love it. And so we stalled the other landlord, and we're just like, you know, we're like, wait. So we got the lights on. We went to see it with my partner, and I was like, this is the one. And that's how we found it.
There you go.
Wasn't that, now that's a lot of, I mean, right there we could have a whole business show because first of all, you said you would find some place you loved and they'd say, well, you're so young and maybe it won't work. We've never had it before. Do we want people flying around?
Exactly.
And if they fly out the window, are we... No, I mean, a landlord has to think that way.
Yeah.
And maybe the parking and how many will it upset the neighbors and everything else. So that's one area. there must have been a lot of disappointment, though, as you're getting turned down. You say, gee, this is a perfect spot. And that, at least you thought so. Mm-hmm. Now, I think Mineola is actually a great location. Mm-hmm. With it's so close to the communications. You've got the courts, you've got the hospitals, you've got the train there. So you've got so many big things locally to you, and so much availability, and you're close to the city. So it's like win-win all the way across. Yeah. But what kept you up when that disappointment hit?
It's just my passion for it. I knew that this is something that I wanted to do for years, so nothing was going to stop me. I would get sad maybe for like a few hours sometimes, you know, maybe a day, but no more than that. And the next day I would wake up, all right, we're going to go again.
And Corey, do you know that's the key word with all entrepreneurs? If they have a passion for what they're doing, because you're signing a lease, and it's like, the bridge just fell after you crossed it. Mm-hmm. There's no going back.
Exactly.
For 5 years or 10 years or 50 years, you're going to be an aerial loft person, and you got this loft and you have to pay rent on it. Now, tell our audience again, where is the loft located and the website?
Yeah. So we're located at 267 Horton Highway in Mineola, Long Island. And the website is theaerialloft.com. And you can also reach us at theaerialloft@gmail.com with any other questions. And the same for us, all of our social medias. It's The Aerial Loft.
And are you open every day?
We're open Monday through Sunday, 7 days a week. On weekdays, we're open in the evenings from 5 to 10 p.m. And then on weekends, we're open from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
That's a hectic schedule. And again, just to make it easy for our audience, you had given me an easy reference point because people who don't know Mineola may not know Horton Highway. But you said that's about one block off of Jericho Turnpike by, what was the catering house?
Yeah, so actually we're directly behind the Jericho Terrace, like across the street from it. Behind,
so easy location to find if they're looking for it and to go out there.
Not hard to miss.
It's, exactly.
You were saying it's 2,000 square feet facility?
Yeah.
So what are the future plans for the Aerial Loft? You have all these classes. Are you planning on adding any more or maybe adding another silk rig?
Yeah, for sure. I'm open to everything. If there's a new class, I want it to come to the Aerial Loft and have it there for my clients to try it out. So I'm kind of just like open to everything.
Take us through a typical day for you. Now, we always think we see, you know, the lawyer show on TV or the teacher. We see the fun parts of it or they put a little drama in. But there's the parts that aren't so glamorous, too. There's 6 hours sitting in the library researching the medical or the legal. Mm-hmm. Take us through your typical day.
Sure. I'll give you, like, a typical day for me. I try to wake up and I check my emails and things, and then I try and get to the gym, and I'll be on the treadmill getting my workout on, and then I get an email or a call, and it's like, we need this to happen. So I have to like run out, leave the gym, go to the studio, go handle whatever situation is going on. And then 4 days out the week, I'm teaching as well. So in the evenings, I'll teach classes. And then Saturday mornings, I'm there teaching classes. And then I'm there doing work a little late, and then I'll lock up and head home.
So you started out saying you go to the gym first yourself to have a separate workout besides all this.
Yeah.
I would think I would sleep late those days and just get to bed early, and that would be my life.
Yeah.
But thankfully, you enjoy what you do. And you've given us great insight into what it takes to be an entrepreneur and to do this. And you look really happy with what you do in life.
Thank you.
So, you know, there's a lot of people out there that are grumpy every day they go to work. You look like you're happy with it. So
I am.
You're very fortunate. We want to thank our guest, Regina Armand, the owner of Aerial Loft, a dance and fitness studio in Mineola. Regina, thank you.
Thank you so much.
And I'd like you to know that I'm Bill Horan. I'm here with Corey Kaufman. And we thank you for listening to this week's edition of My Hometown.
We'd like to get your feedback on My Hometown. Send your comments to whpc@ncc.edu. Nassau Community College, where success starts and continues. Till next time, this is Bill St. James. And remember, there's no town like your hometown.